Avengers, good. There's someone who wants to talk to you. I believe some of you know Kate Bishop, formerly Hawkeye.
Oh, we've met. FYI, call me Katie and an arrow ends up in your eye. Tony! Hey!
Nuh-uh. If I can't call you Katie, there's no way you get to call me Tony.
Old nicknames, then? Iron Pants?
Nuh-uh.
Bucket Man?
No.
Tin Titan?
Kinda like that one.
Well, that takes the fun out of it.
So you're working for S.H.I.E.L.D. now?
It's, complicated.
Where's Clint?
That's complicated, too.
Agent Barton was captured by AIM a few years back. There's been very little intel since.
Clint and I were looking into what happened to Director Fury after A-Day. Something didn't seem right about the story AIM was telling. Must have gotten too close. We stumbled on this Tachyon project, and then Clint was gone too. It has to be connected. The Tachyon disruptions, Clint, Fury, everyone who gets close to these things disappears. But now we know there's one guy at the center of it all. Dr. Lyle Getz. We get him to spill his guts on the project, then we can go in and, shut it down.
And you think we can convince him to flip?
Convince, make him question all his life decisions. You know, we'll see how it goes.
Simple, I like it.
Ready when you are, Iron Pants.
Hey, Kate, hang on a sec.
Yeah, what's up?
We're not gonna talk about this. You know we thought you were dead. Nobody heard from you.
I tried contacting you in the early days. Nothing. You expected me to keep calling after 5 years? I know you guys probably had your reasons, but you made it pretty clear we were on our own.
I thought it would be safer for you that way. Everyone who was there on A-Day was poison. A target. But things are different now. If you wanted to come back.
We'll see.
Hey, I got a little something set up in the harm room for you.
Are you saying I need to practice? Because it sounds like you're saying I need to practice.
No, no, I'm saying if you need to stay sharp or blow off some steam, get in some cardio.
You know I'm just messing with you, right?
Right. Right. Is it weird that I missed it? No, don't answer that. It's weird. I know it's weird.
Ah, good old Tony Stark. Making things a little bit more awkward than they need to be. Nah. But alright, people. Let's just get into this real quick and see what we got to do here with Kate. Let's see. She got a harm training mission. I actually think I should check out her gears because I'm level 1. I want to see if I at least got something. No, okay. I should have known that I don't have anything. This is the first time even controlling Kate. As for her skills, okay. Yeah, I can't wait to get this started so we can unlock some of her gear, but I gotta find what her mission is. I see it. Okay.
All right. Surveillance footage shows this dude heading into the facility at like 5 a.m. No recorded exit, so he should still be here.
Do we know anything else about this guy?
Oh, yeah. Dr. Lyle Getz. He specializes in robotics and particle physics and other nerd crap. Joined AIM in the early days, and also, grade A creep.
Glad that part of my report stayed on the record. While I was undercover, he started working on something top secret. I could never get clearance to find out what.
Well, let's rifle through his sock drawer while we're here.
Oh, I plan to.
Okay, let's go find Getz. We'll have to get past security first.
Not seeing a way for you to sneak through. They've got the area covered. It's gonna be a fight.
You ready for this, Kate?
I'm not the one who spent the last 5 years playing air guitar, my dude. Follow my lead.
How does she know about that? Was she spying on him?
All right, let's get to higher ground. See if we can spot the fortress from here.
I'm detecting a prisoner convoy up ahead. Prisoners.
Okay.
Fortress facility.
not really traversing.
If AIM wants to make new friends, they'll just have to awkwardly socialize like the rest of us.
While cutting you up, I'm just going to say that I should have went to the harm room first, because it probably would have told me how to maneuver, unless it's something I have to unlock. Because I'm not sure, because I'm pretty sure her, the way she like teleports around the map is, it's tied to her intrinsic meter, and I'm not sure sure if I have to unlock it or not. Now she's dangerous from afar and up close. She's definitely somebody you don't want to mess with. I don't know what's worse, her arrows or that sword. Put that down, Mr. Freeze. Or discount Mr. Freeze. Oh, one of the things gave him the shield. See, that's what I was talking about in the last episode. I don't like that yellow stuff, so I'm going to take, we'll take him down. He won't be shielded anymore. Oh, no you don't. Explode, my guy. Eat explosive arrows. You know, she moves really nice. Yo. 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 I wonder if we could do that to people. I mean, I know we can do the takedown. I'm talking about the blowing off the top half part. Okay, piece of gear. Let's just get rid of you. You don't see anything. You know, I actually don't like the ones that shoot the rockets at me, because out of everything that those turrets do, I get hit by those the most. It's like my reaction time with those rockets will sometimes be like what's the term? Like bad. It's gonna say it's just really bad. Nice, got some gear and some resources. Really, we got some resources. Yeah, no, we got a little gear. Okay, cool. I really gotta figure out what it is, because I know I could do something, because you can link her teleports with her attack, so it's really gonna be good for like mob battles. And no, I thought I was still doing something wrong with that, and that's not it. I'll learn it, I'll get the hang of it, then you're gonna see me just going off on people. Till then, I'll do stuff like that. Oh my, is that the ice adaptoid? You Sub-Zero ripoff, bring it on. Decoy and Widow put us invisible. You can't hit what you can't see. What you can't see, you can't hit. Oh, nice. Pretty much springboarded off his face. Nice. I mean, granted, low level, because Kate's only level one, but still, I'm enjoying it. You won't see this coming at all, you sapsucker. I missed. That would have been really cool if I could have nailed that shot. Just saying. Would have been a real badass moment. I really hate you ice dudes. Scatter arrows are genius, though. I need to get the smokescreen arrows so I can blind my enemies and I'll be able to like sneak up on them and stuff. Kind of makes me want to play as Psylocke, because I know she got the whole sword thing going on too, and she got the psychic powers, but that's more suited to if there was a X-Men style game in this fashion. Ooh, imagine a good X-Men game after all these years, getting to play as Storm, Nightcrawler. That would be a dream right there. You probably only see me play as Storm because she's my favorite X-Men character. And honestly, it's about time we should be able to play as Professor X. You're like, oh, man, ooh, okay. Yeah, see, like that. I got to be able to do something like that with my intrinsic. All right, we got it. You guys are too late. We got to go. But, yeah, like I was saying about the whole X-Men thing. Like, being Professor X, I wouldn't mind. Like, okay, he's in a wheelchair. He's fucked people up from a wheelchair before. A long time ago, he was a mega level threat mutant when he became Onslaught. Because only reason I know about this Onslaught thing is because I was actually talking with my uncle and cousin about it the other day. It was about when Magneto had pulled the adamantium right out of Wolverine, and it had pissed Professor X off so bad that he went to purge Magneto's mind. But while purging Magneto's mind, something jumped into his mind and turned him into like this insane killer mutant. I need to read that. I want to read that series. Because I just want to see how powerful he, like, he got, or like the stuff he did. Really, I just really want to see like Professor X go off. Because they give Professor X some cool things to do and stuff like that, but I feel like they sideline him more than he needs to be. But yeah, you know, that's just my little thought on it. Like, if you get an X-Men game, I hope Professor X is playable instead of sitting on the sideline watching everybody else have all the fun. Okay, aim up there. This is just a little bit different from the other containment things that they normally have us do. And in a way, I kind of hope they keep these so it's a little bit mixed up. Instead of punching the sides of the machines, you know, shoot at these things. I didn't get to it quick enough. This is just easy that I want to do over. This is good because everybody can do this. Cap can throw a shield at it. Iron Man shoots. Kamala can stretch your arm punch. We'll shoot you guys out the sky. Uh-oh, invisible decoy, let's go. I like how Black Widow does that at the same time I do mine. Okay, no, he's asking for it. Oh my, he asking for it. Tired of you. Die. Die. I'm trying to free people. You know what another game I like for Marvels is actually the Fantastic Four. Like, I know there was a Fantastic Four back in the day. I played a little bit of it, but I can't remember if it was good or not. So, given how much time has passed and the failure of the most recent Fantastic Four movie, like, I don't know what the hell they were thinking. Maybe a game can do it right, because sometimes you can't tell a good story. And that's two. In the time slot that a movie might allow, but with a game and the right developers and the right studio, you can get that done. And I'm just saying, I would like to see that. And if not the Fantastic Four, maybe Guardians of the Galaxy. Yeah, let's go with that.
Transport logs indicate there are more prisoners trapped inside the facility. Three scientists unaffiliated with AIM.
Well, let's go pay them a visit.
Okay, let's resume our journey to the ominous prison fortress.
You got some nice gadgets, Kane. They're not shield issue, are they?
I just happened to meet some AIM folk who just happened to misplace their highly expensive equipment. Only took a few modifications.
Convenient.
Short-range teleporter, invisibility cloak. They're surprisingly intuitive.
I know, right? Nothing better than beating AIM with their own gear. I love violent girl talk.
Me too. But hey, you know, let me know down in the comments, like, what type of game would y'all prefer? Because in my eyes, like, an X-Men game, a Fantastic Four game, or a Guardians of the Galaxy game can all be made in a similar fashion as this. Obviously, not as rushed as this one technically was, but you know, the formula still works. Just that when you have gear, a gear system, that it actually affects the outfit, like it affects the appearance. I mean, cause that's really all I want out of this, is to affect the appearance of my outfit with certain gear. Like how Injustice does it. Like the gear pieces changes the core look of the outfit. And there's tons of different gear pieces, but there's only five or six different looks for each piece. They could have done that with this, you know. But yeah, let me know down below in the comment what type of Marvel game would y'all like done in this style. I'm still leaning towards the X-Men, only because it's been a while. And how can I hit that from here? You know, how about we just jump over? Exactly. Okay, so we got the two down there. We got the two up here, and then I gotta figure out where. Okay, I gotta figure out where the A is. I see it's down there somewhere. Might be on the floor or something. You guys seriously don't have to follow me right here. Just wait down here. Okay. The other one is where? Let's get a step back and look. It is. There it is.
Time to make our grand entrance.
Hope we match the dress code.
Oh, haven't you heard? Tonight's dress code is aim in pain.
My God, that's awful. I love it.
Question, like, how are people supposed to get into this facility? Do the robots have to open it for them? For, like, the scientists? Or what? Like, do they get scanned in or something? Because that would be tedious if you didn't have no robots. And you was just a plain scientist. You wouldn't be getting in at all.
Catherine Elizabeth Bishop, daughter of Derek and Eleanor.
Don't say my whole government.
Private investigator.
Sapsucker.
And former Avenger. Oh, wait. They abandoned you before that ever became official, didn't they?
Stalker?
Not
much?
Like his mama abandoned.
Did he hear us, Jarvis?
Oh, we've got top surveillance on you, Avengers.
Oh, good. That means I can tell you to butts off, intercom guy.
Try not to die before I see you in the flesh, Ms. Bishop.
Dying. I'm too cute to die, baby.
You're right. This Getz guy's a creep.
Severely. It is nice to hear Aloy's voice again.
Guess we lost the element of surprise. Nothing but resistance from this point onward.
Oh,
that's another
I'm
thing I
can it.
Find solace in.
First we break these
solace,
out,
I mean.
Then we find Getz.
I find solace in knowing that. Because that playthrough we did, oh God, Horizon Zero Dawn, although it was long, I enjoyed it. I enjoyed the story it told, and I enjoyed Aloy's voice acting. And then hear her again as Kate Bishop, especially since she's using arrows. I feel like it was just meant to be. Yeah, I was about to say, Kamala, just put hands on them real quick. Do a Hulk taught you and just
smash.
Oh, we got one of those. Like, you guys have to give me a minute. I'm just like obsessed with trying to figure out where these things be at. And it teaches you to kind of watch your environment too. And usually doing that highlight where they might be. So what I gotta do, we're just gonna look around the area, go where we can go and see where everything is. Like there. Yep, it's in there. These things be hiding in like some of the most weirdest of places though. You don't really think to look in the goddamn fan. You just see yellow and think maybe. So now I gotta look for a possible another fan that it might be in. And we looked on the first floor, so let's look on this floor, see if it's up here. Well, we did find some resources though. We'll be taking all of these. Oh, how about these? These are yellow. Get them here. Oh, I can't cut the glass. Okay, that ain't nothing. Like, I know this is probably not important to y'all, but like, this is something. See, there goes the other one. Okay. But it's important. I find it a little important because you never know. It could be some good level gear. Like, you decide to not do this, right? Because you can't find these. Or maybe because it might be just a tad bit too tedious. You might be passing up on some legendary level gear. Because all gear comes at can come at any level. I can get a low level legendary gear, but it will be great. Let's see what we ended up getting. Got something for the sword. It's green, so I think that is rare, right? I keep forgetting. Alright. Let's go in here and beat up this creepy ass doctor.
Looks like we reached the lab. Prison. All of the above.
Avengers! Get us out of here! Please!
There should be a console somewhere to lower the barriers. Let's get these people out of here.
Well, Dr. Getz, I am.
Hey, we know. It's okay. What's Getz keeping you here for?
Experimental robotics engineering. We mainly integrate this strange tech they got from somewhere.
They don't know anything. You're wasting your time.
How can I communicate with these guys? Where I was, they clearly don't have our radio people. Unless they got cozy and very convenient prison cells. You know, a warp arrow would have been really great, actually. Let's play to try it. And he took the hit. Dang. Come on in, cryo sucker. Oh, man, I am into the whole bus, man. You gotta chill, my guy. Nice. So I'm gonna slash you with the sword, you know. I'm gonna have some chinks in his armor. Don't worry, guy. We're coming to bust you out.
I'm beaming with pride.
The cryo adaptoid. I am so underwhelmed with those guys. Although the boss was supposed to be like a super adaptoid, looks promising. I hope he's not underwhelming either.
Safety.
Free to go.
We'll handle Getz.
Wait, so is Theo coming to get him or what? I really can't see because of God dang it. You better not be following me, guy. Yeah, I think you know better. Oh. Yeah. Oh my god, these scatter arrows are so useful. Yeah, he won't be in Marvel's Avengers. And speaking about a possible Marvel Avengers 2, I'm excited about the prospect of it having to do with the Kree soldiers. Mainly because Captain Marvel will have to be in the main roster for that. And honestly, hopefully sticking with this story, Kate sticks around too.
Ooh, looks like you lost your scientist, Getz.
A minor setback. They'll be replaced soon enough. Everyone is expendable. Except me.
Uh-huh. We'll just see
hey
about
Jarvis,
that.
How full is that Quinjet?
We've room to spare, Miss Bishop. What are you planning, Kate?
Oh, we're just gonna grab Dr. Getz and take him with us. There's no way I'm letting him go after this.
You really are a Hawkeye. Lead the way.
Yes, I shall. I'm not saying, but anyway, I'm not saying that I would prefer Kate over Clint. Actually, they both seem like they're pretty good. And that makes me excited for Hawkeye, because I believe Hawkeye is coming out next. So, I'm excited to see how he plays in difference to her. And maybe they might both be in the Marvel's Avengers 2 or something like that. But for what I'm seeing, for at least for how I ended, and then what I learned from this other YouTuber, I forgot his name. And he was basically informing his viewers that the Kree Sentry.
Violence is so common, but I'd expect no better from Hawkeye's protege.
that.
Let's try my common arrows against.
You know, baby girl tried the same thing, and she ended up getting, well, she didn't get paddled, but she ended up getting the ass handed to her.
I'd listen to her. I'm scared.
Oh, he shoots more than one. Okay. Okay. So, yeah, okay. Talking and trying to do this is a little difficult, but. If I could just try to get this out real fast. Basically, that Crescent MODOK used was there to monitor the Inhumans. Like, the Terrigen that turned Kamala into this quote unquote Inhuman isn't a new thing. Inhumans have actually been there from like the beginning. The Kree first sent that sentry to the planet, and from time to time he would send reports back. And it's believed that thing that came out of his chest and shot into the sky was the final report from the sentry before, I guess, and it powered down and died. So she'll be seeing the Kree in the possible sequel, which means Captain Marvel. I really want to call her Miss Marvel so bad. It's hard to keep saying Captain Marvel when you've known her as Miss Marvel for so long. And hopefully she's handled way better than the MCU did. Like, it's rare for the MCU to have misses in their movies, in their live action movies. Normally that's DC's thing, with like Batman being the one that carries it. Superman and this Man of Steel was pretty decent. Wonder Woman is pretty good, and Aquaman was one of the best movies they had so far. So, they're starting to show hope, and then you got them somehow butchering the whole Captain Marvel thing. Like, made it so disinteresting. And I believe I said it last episode where I fell asleep trying to watch the movie twice. No, you don't. Oh, yes, it does. I don't know. I would like to write a movie though one day. Sucker. Yeah, shoot your homeboy. Alright, I'll shoot him. My sword. Oh, you can't excuse. Ooh, I'm glad I got that takedown going. I would have got all types of hits by that. Okay. God. I'm not gonna lose to you guys. I know we all the same level, but I refuse. I refuse to lose to these guys. You're only like level 2 or 3. Now. Okay, so what is this? Is this, is Guess doing that? Is that, do we hit that and engage it? Whatever it is, I don't plan on getting next to it. And I didn't dodge. I was too focused on shooting gas with this arrow. God. How ranged abilities feel so powerful. Like, you feel more powerful than Iron Man's, Widow. Honestly, I think her arrows might be a little bit more higher caliber than even what Widow's guns do. Especially since, you know, quantum warp arrows and stuff like that. So I'm guessing, yeah, they are higher caliber. Especially if you throw a quantum into the mix. And how about I get away from that? Yeah. A little bit more, Dr. Gans. Your bald ass gonna be coming with us.
Bishop takes King. Checkmate, Doc.
Let's get him back to the ship.
Ready for extraction.
Nice little pun. You're very punny, Kate.
Let's drop him off at the substation. Maybe Maria can get some information out of him.
Dr. Creep's about to spill some beans.
Great. Now I'm hungry.
So, Getz, how are you liking the accommodations?
Did you come here just to gloat?
I did.
But, you know, we can cut to the chase if you want. Maria, Dr. Getz, we're well aware of your position in AIM's organization.
If you're referring to my demotion, It's a jealous vendetta by that Rappaccini, Harpy.
Ooh, so Monica's not happy with you either, huh?
Yeah, he couldn't paddle that ass.
She didn't appreciate your little Tachyon disaster, did she?
I never mentioned Tachyon.
Oh, come on, dude. The storms, massive radiation spikes. It's your work, isn't it?
Was. My work was never this unstable. What Rappaccini's doing is reckless, suicidal. Now, get me a lawyer.
Boop. Duh. Ooh, I don't think so.
It doesn't really matter, though. I already scanned your, facial structure. A little 3D hard light simulation in your security systems will think my Getz decoy is the real thing.
I can see why Rappaccini was so interested in you. Your skills are impressive.
What do you mean, interested? Someone that could paddle that ass.
She's quite taken with both you and the other Hawkeye. It's a shame you chose the wrong side.
Feeling like I made the right choice from here? You know, outside the prison cell? We're done. Guards.
Don't let them get to you. These guys always try to mess with your head.
Yeah, maybe, but I still need to look into this. If AIM was keeping tabs on Clint, I need to know what they have.
Well, we can help.
You guys made your priorities clear. Clint wasn't on the list. You know what, I get it. The Avengers have a world to save, you can't just drop everything. But I'm not giving up on my friend. I'll be back soon.
Shot.
Yeah, well, it's all in the breathing.
Oh God, Cap!
A bunch of other steps.
Oh my God, that whole... Whoa.
Either I'm in trouble.
So much for fixing any discrepancies in the game.
We all made mistakes. And that meant we were there for you when you needed us most.
Cap, you were taken prisoner. You've got nothing to apologize for.
Yes, I do. I didn't prepare the team to go on without me.
Nightmare fuel.
Also, I should have made this official a long time ago.
That's quite the fascist statement there, Mr. Rogers.
If you'll have us.
When I was a kid, I dreamed of hearing you say that. I also dreamed of flying a plane made of gumballs.
I'm hoping that's a yes.
I'll give it a shot.
This, you see? You ruined it, Cap. With whatever the hell you got going on, you ruined it. Oh, my dear lord.
Your work paid off, Avengers. Whew. I sent the intel you gathered onto Dr. Pym. He'll get you up to speed.
Kate's taking the lead on this one. Report to the war table when you're ready.
Okay. But yeah, so Monica had her eye on good old Kate and Clint. Why? Because Hawkeye specializes in always hitting the mark. And when it comes to paddling that ass, you always gotta hit the mark. But until next time, people. I need you to like, comment, and subscribe if you enjoyed this episode and you want to see more Kate Bishop. And as always, stay safe. Wear your face mask. And practice that social distancing. And I'll be back with more Kate Bishop and Miles Morales in the future. Until next time, everyone. Peace out.